Vata? Yuri? Can you hear me?
Atmospheric entry imminent.
Where is everyone? Did anyone
Please
make it to the ground pods? Eamon! Vars! Is anyone there?
Welcome everybody to a new game with me, Vapor, and we're going to be playing the Solus Project. And oh my god, was that not Subnautica all over again? Me and space travel clearly don't mix, as we seem to get shot down every time we approach a planet. The first time I loaded this game up, now my PC isn't like top-end PC, defaulted to ultra settings. And yeah, the game would never load, so if any of you are playing this and you're having issues, it might be worth checking that. I think I've got most things set to high, and, well, as you can see, it is quite beautiful. We'll go with a normal. I'm not going to go hard, and I'm not going to go easy. I don't know the ins and outs of the game. All I know, it's a survival game, much like Subnautica, but I think there's a bit more story in this one. I think it's potentially a little bit further along. Yeah, so we're going to jump right in, I think. Fahrenheit, feet, miles, invert look. Yeah, we're fine with that. I'm not very good with Celsius. Feet miles is fine with me as well. Okay. Firstly, it is very, very beautiful. Without a shadow of a doubt. So we've got a little computer.
World Independent Local Survival Overseer Node Active. Wilson interfacing with operator.
Wilson.
Vital signs detected.
That's very Castaway, isn't it? Just call me Castaway Vay from now on, I think. Wilson! That's quite cool. So, we've got various statistics there. I'm guessing the 532 next to the plus is my health. We've got my body temperature. I'm guessing the external temperature next to that. Sleep. Calories. I think the one below that's water. And then the other water kind of droplet with a percentage, I will assume, is humidity and obviously wind speed, but I guess we'll find things out as we move along. Oh, that's a bit unusual. When you start walking initially, you don't start moving like at full speed. So that's the drop pod that we dropped in. Now, he mentioned two names as he was coming down there. I caught one was Yuri, but I don't know what the other one was, so I'm guessing there was at least two other people on this ship with him, the one that blew up, that is. So, items have two states, pick up an item and craft combine with another item. So I'm guessing the two different colours, maybe. So, left mouse button to pick up. Okay, you've got to keep hold of it. Now that's gone orange, so heavy, multi-use, so I can do something with these two. Smash them together by the looks of it. So how do we put them away? Well, right click drops it. Left click picks it up. So we have some kind of weapon. Alright, I'm guessing this is the way out. Can be cut, requires tool. Oh, just so happens I have a sharp rock. Aha. Oh, here we go. Stats. Sleep and objectives. Okay, have I got to remember those keys? I'm going to have to write these things down. Oh my goodness. Why is it BS? Sorry, Sleep. Stats. Oh, goodness. Okay. Yeah, I think we already got that. So, survive for 0 days. Okay, and B. Okay. So we don't want to sleep just yet anyway, but we can select how long. Alright, so that's how you pick up. You just click on it now. I'm guessing C is crouch. Yes. I want to put this rock away, but I'm not sure how you do it. It's not told me yet. So we've got some water, or at least a carton. So we've got a clothes can we can pick up. Ooh. You find yourself in a precarious situation. Explore your surroundings and scavenge whatever useful items you can find before conditions worsen. Wow. As soon as you can, secure a source of heat, fresh water and food. Find a place to take shelter. How you deal with the first few hours is crucial for your survival. I think I'd probably say how you deal with it full stop will decide how long I survive, because you can make a mistake pretty quickly. And you can make a mistake quite far on into the game too, so. Wow, the light shining off that rock. I'm guessing there's nothing out here. I'm not going to venture into the sea, because if Subnautica's taught me anything, there's some big fish out there, more than likely. But we will explore fully, so. The way I'm going to play this game, there's one thing I do know, there is hidden areas, so if I miss something, you don't have to full on tell me if you know it, but kind of point me in the right direction. But I will be taking my time, I will be exploring, so this might be a slightly slower playthrough than you're probably used to, but at least if you're trying to learn things or you want to watch me explore.
Please follow survival training.
Yes, boss. Yeah.
It's so, all up in flames.
Oh.
I need to last long enough to report something back to Prolus Command. Better have a look around and see if anything or anyone survived.
So Prolus Command, I'm guessing, I think that they said the ship they launched from Earth, the colony ship, was Prolus, if I remember rightly from what I read. So there is still people out there. We're not kind of the last people when it comes to humanity, so take the water. But there was at least, I'm assuming, three of us. Crafting a torch. Create a makeshift cutting tool using rocks, which we've done. Cut off any dry organic material, which we've not. We've got some wire. Wrap the material around some kind of handle. Apply oil to it if available. E. Light it on fire. Well, we've got a pole. So, we've got another pole now too. Excellent. Really? A VCR? How retro are we getting? We're in the future. What was it, 2150 something? My goodness. Oh, can we eat these? Mushrooms. Maybe not necessarily a good idea. Aha. Dry roots. Excellent. We pick them up. So it's telling me where to go to a rough degree, and I can see at the top of the little PDA, it lets me know kind of how far away I am, which is quite cool. What we got here? So that's another rock, yeah. Okay, we've got some more roots. Actually, kind of like the way this game is set out. It's taking me a little time to get used to, I guess. We've got another rock here as well. I can hear water. Oh, so we can just drink directly from it. Well, that's not a little bit dangerous, isn't it? Just drinking water straight from a rock face on an alien planet. What's the worst that could happen? Is that water as well? Yeah. Slightly dangerous. So, I need to find out. Aha, tab. Just like Subnautica. So, cable for climbing. I'm gonna drop that for now if I can. I'm guessing if we leave it here, it'll be safe. Food. I'm gonna drop some of it, I think. I'll keep hold of one for now. We got a rock, and we'll drop some of these water bottles. Can we fill it up? That's a good question. That sounds like I'm drinking it, not actually filling the bottle up. Is it empty? Aha. Well, it's got water. Ah, I can see it inside. There we go. Excellent. So we have our pole. And do we have to do it this way? Okay. I'm guessing we can't just drag and drop. Select an item, a pipe. We have a stick. With a fro, I guess. Well, that's going to be my version of Wilson, I think. It looks like a person. So why is it sending me now? Forward vector. Scavenge some food. Ah, so we don't need the tin can necessarily. We're just going to eat some random food that we found. Why not? So calories are quite high. Now, I think the average male, is it 2,500 calories a day? So we do need to eat some more. That's for sure, from what I can see. So we've got to keep our eyes open for mushrooms. Is that noise coming from this? Oh, that's going to take my hair off, isn't it? And if you actually look, I'm going to move this to the side of this. If you actually look where you've got the temperature, you can see the heat's actually going up being near it. So I guess if I get cold, what's this? Ah, oil. So we've now got an oiled stick. So I'm guessing, yep, we're going to tempt fate and stick our head near this. This is just clever, isn't it? It's only about 100 degrees. 188 degrees. Holy crap. Oh my god, that must have set fire to me as well. Oh yeah. That can't have been good. 134 degrees. Wow. I think I cooked myself a little bit there. Oh, it's connected to something. I guess we're Solus 3. Is that heat the sun? I'm getting cooked by the sun. Holy crap, this is a hot planet. Let's go and jump in our cave. Oh my, that sun is seriously close. I didn't realize. I thought it was a graphical issue because of the torch, but let's go inside. Wow, there goes the temperature. Holy crap. That is some serious sunlight. So we've got 12 and a half hours until we need to sleep by the looks of it. Okay, so fine for water. We need to eat some food, maybe. So we can drop this can. So I'm guessing I can survive it because nothing happened. But look at the temperature now, it's 48 degrees Fahrenheit. And I'm 99.5, so let's go up just here. I'm more interested in my temperature. Like, is that moon looks like it's on fire. Okay. That is okay. It's getting to night time now. I can hear the... Is that another star behind that moon? Or that planet? see a little bit of light like, starting to hide behind it. Wow, that was nuts. Well, I don't need my torch right now, so we're going to carry on having a look around. So I guess the environment can quite literally, well, I don't know if it's going to kill me, but that is some serious sunlight. Okay, well, it's not giving me any of the forward vectors, so we're just going to have a little bit of a look around. Okay, I'm guessing we need to head towards that. Whoa. They're Venus flytraps of epic proportions. Oh, what are we going here? So, Lata's diary, 1 of 26. I decided to start a journal since I was assigned to the Solus Project. It's an honour to be one of the few selected to save humanity. Oh, there, put my teeth in. Humanity. And I want to record that. It's probably a suicide mission, but staying on Prolus is suicide anyway. Well, fair point, I guess. Surprisingly numb after saying goodbye to all my friends and loved ones. Perhaps it'll hit me later. I don't even feel nothing. This is one of the greatest moments in human history. I guess changes in anesthetic. Met my new colleagues again today. I'll be working closely with Sophia. Said she's worried about leaving her family behind too. And I will lend an ear if I want. What? Let me read that again. Her family behind too, and will lend an ear if I want to. Oh, right. So that's saying basically she might not want to, I guess. Seems nice. She has kids though. That's a far more bitter pill to swallow. Well, yeah, if humanity's about to die, you don't only have to think about yourself. Well, you can see the sun is only there now. It looks tiny, but damn, it was cooking us. Well, there's plenty of food and things around. I don't know how much I can actually hold. No, I don't want to craft. I want to pick it up. Got another pole. I swear I can hear something. Yeah, crickets, that's for sure. Sophia sounds like a one-track record. Always going on about her family. Being her driving passion. Oh, let me come back down. So I missed what it said. Because it goes pretty quickly. Having all that doesn't guarantee happiness or meaning in your life. I get the impression she's trying to make me reevaluate my priorities. I think that's generally what people do. A friend of mine recently had a child and yeah, that's his driving force now. That's all he seems to talk about, which is fair enough, I guess. 15 years Earth time, but only 8 years for us. Times flow slower when you travel a substantial fraction of speed of light. When I told my friends, they said it was trippy. They wanted more explanation, but we don't get much time per week, so I cut it short. Okay. Launch day. I guess this is it. I still haven't processed it. We're all sat at the crow's nest. Oh my god, it goes too quick for me to read. Yeah, we're also at the crow's nest and watched as our big shining home grew smaller and smaller. So this is the planet we're on now, is it? Gliese? I can't really quite pronounce that. It's 15 years away and this is only the first step. And those things just are dying to eat me. I'm not going to be walking into those. Is that what I can hear? It must have been them. I can hear what sounds like insects. I'm not even sure if I should go anywhere near that. Any plant that moves can't be a good thing. It's probably going to try and eat me or something. What's that? Ah, oh, food. Excellent. Oh, I can hear a fly. Why can't I get that? There we go. Oh, drinking water. I didn't want... Oh, that must have been nice. Where's the, where's that? We need to eat that. Nights are very cold. Okay, the temperature is dropping. Got some more VCR tapes. What on earth? It's really funny. Maybe I should be inside. Let me bring my torch out. So that's going to supply some heat, isn't it? Not really by the looks of it. Well, I don't want to freeze to death, so I might head back towards our cave. But at least we've explored a little bit, that's the main thing. I'm not really seeing anything else over here. It doesn't mean that there isn't anything. What's that over there? That looks slightly man-made. I mean, I'm not seeing anything that I would say was man-made here. Most of this looks like parts of our vessel. Oh, that is just beautiful, isn't it? And I'm guessing the rocks. I've seen these before. I'm no geologist, but I think it's something to do with volcanoes. So I could be wrong, but I know these exist. I'm not freezing to death, am I? 64 degrees. My main concern at the moment is food. What time is it now? 10 hours. Well, let's sleep for a couple of hours and maybe get through the night. That might be a good idea. And we're surviving so far, which is a good start, I guess. We've not killed ourselves. Right, now how did we sleep? I think it was P, wasn't it? Was it P? No. Oh, health limit 600 of a max of 1,200. So 12 of 36 inventory. Okay. That was B. So let's sleep for 5 hours. I don't know how long the day-night cycle is in this game. But I'm sure we'll soon find out. Because it had just turned night. Yep. I'm awake, and I'm probably going to be thirsty and hungry, because I usually am when I wake up. Oh no. I really need some food. That's my only worry at the moment, so let's smash this can open. Did I just pick that up? Yeah, I did. So let's drop that can. Select an item. Okay, that didn't work. But oh, it's in my inventory. That's why it's here. Ooh, that doesn't look nice, does it, at all? Wow, we got a lot of calories off that, though. That's not too bad. So let's get rid of the can, because I'm guessing we don't need that. Let's go and have a look. Well, it's still pretty dark. What is that? Oh, it is cold. Look, I can see the ice around my my helmet, I guess. I'm gonna go and did I just see a flashing light out here, or am I seeing things? Smoke is like ice. I swear I saw a flashing light out there. Right, I'm going to stand somewhere here. Yeah, that's going to warm me up a little bit. I mean, I literally don't want to stand in it. There is a flashing light. I saw it again. So there's something definitely out there. Now, whether it's something off our ship, or whether it's something that was already here, I don't know. I'm a little bit hot, I think. Yeah, we'll stand here. Getting toasted. Well, I think that's a good place to leave the episode. We've survived our landing. We've got shelter. We've got some food. Not an inexhaustible amount of food, I might add. But we've got water. That seems kind of like an abundant source. So we need to secure food, I guess. But we're going to go and explore along the beach in the next episode. So, until next time, as always, take care.